Hello students and welcome to our class of linear equation in one variable. Today we will see exercise 2.2, the first five questions. Exercise 2.2, the first five questions deals about application of the linear equations in real life. If you are given a question, you have to apply it and find the equation and get the solution. Okay. Now, in the first question, it is asked, something is asked and some things are given to you. Okay, what you need to do is, you have to read the question properly and convert the worded question into numbers and then get your equation to solve. Okay, let's read. If you subtract half from a number, now word problems always come with parts. So you have to read very carefully for each step. Okay. So, if you subtract half from a number, what does this mean? There is a number and you are subtracting half from it. Okay, let's go to the second part. So, this is our first part up till here. And it says, multiply the result. Whatever you are getting here, multiply the result by half. So, this is our second part. This is our first part. You get 1 upon 8. So, final answer we are getting is 1 upon 8. What is the number? This is the question and where we are going to start from. What is the number means? We don't know the number. It is a variable. Okay. So, we have to start with the last thing. What is the number? We will write, let the number be x. We don't know the number, so we will take it as x, a variable. X can be any number. Okay, now it is saying, let's go to part 1 of our question. It says, if you subtract half from the number, a number is x, we are considering x to be that number, and we are going to subtract half from that number to write down our equation. So, x minus half is our first part. Second part is, and multiply that result by half. Of this, multiply the result with half. Okay, now third part, you get 1 upon 8, means after solving all this, we should get 1 upon 8. Now let's read and recheck if we are getting the question and the equation properly. If you subtract half from a number, we have considered x to be the number, subtracted half from the number, and multiply the result by half, multiply the whole thing with half, we get 1 upon 8. So let's now look at this. This is a worded problem which we have put in words and variable. So x minus half, the whole thing is multiplied by half, which gives us 8. Now this looks like a distributive property, a into b minus c, where you multiply a b minus a c. So, half, this looks like a distributive property where A multiplied by B minus C. Okay, so where A into B minus A into C. So, give half for each terms and open the bracket. So, X multiplied by half minus half multiplied by half, which will give us 1 upon 8. This term is only for these two because we are using distributive property. Okay, then just solve this. X into 1 upon 2 means x upon 2 minus, now denominator is same, so you can directly multiply. 1 1s are 1, 2 2s are 4, which is equal to 1 upon 8. Next, we have got 2, 4 and 8, three different numerators, denominators. We have got three different denominators, so take a LCM of them together, lowest common multiple among all three. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8. Table of 2 again, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4 and 2 1s are 2. So the LCM is equal to 2 into 2 into 2, which is equal to 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. 8 is a LCM. So we are going to multiply 8 with all these terms. Okay, so let's put down x upon 2 multiplied by 8 minus 1 upon 4 multiplied by 8, which is equal to 1 upon 8 multiplied by 8. Now you can cross cancel because this is multiplication and get a smaller number. 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. 8 ones are 8, 8 ones are 8. Now let's write down the balance thing. X multiplied by 4 means 4x minus 1 into 2 is 2. Denominator is 1, you can ignore. 1 into 1 is 1. We got our equation. Now solve. So therefore we have 4x is equal to this 2 on the other side. When it goes, it will be added because it is subtracted here. So it will be added, 1 plus 2. So we get 4x is equal to 3. Then x is multiplied with 4 here. The opposite side in transposition method, it will be divided. So we will write x is equal to 3 upon 4. So this is our answer, 3 upon 4. Therefore, we write the number is the number. What is the number was our question. So the number is x equal to 3 upon 4. This is our solution. This question, we are talking about the perimeter of the rectangular swimming pool. Now the perimeter is given for us. So first part is given for us, perimeter. Perimeter means you add the length and the breadth. Rectangle means it has two dimensions, length and breadth. Perimeter means you have to add the boundaries of the given figure. Here it is a rectangle. So after adding, it should be 154 meter. Now it says that the length is 2 meters more. There are two things for a length which is given. It is 2 meters more than twice its breadth. Two things are given of length. It is 2 meters more, that is one thing. Plus it is 2 times its breadth. Okay, 2 times or double its breadth. What are the length and breadth of the pool? Nothing is given about the breadth, but everything is given about the length and the perimeter only it is given. Last question is, what are the length and breadth of the pool which we are starting with? So we will write solution. Length breadth of the pool be x meters. Okay, you can take any other variable. I have taken x. Now we will write, let the length of the pool be, it is 2 meters more and twice its breadth. It is double the breadth, 2 times its breadth, 2 times. Times means multiplication, 2 times the breadth plus 2 meters more. Okay, M is the units, meters. What are the length and breadth of the pool? Now we start with perimeter formula. So perimeter formula means 2 times length and 2 times breadth, which will give you the perimeter of a rectangle. So we will put it together. 2 times length plus 2 times breadth, when you add, you should get the perimeter of rectangle. Okay, let's substitute the values of length, which is given here, what we have wrote down. Let us substitute the value of length, which we have written down here, that is 2x plus 2, and breadth, we have considered it as x meters. So we will write, you can skip the units for now. 2 times length, length is 2x plus 2. Here also it is 2 times length, so multiplication here, plus 2 times breadth, 2 into x. Okay, or you can put multiplication sign, which is equal to, the perimeter is given 154. So we will open the bracket. This is of your distributive type of property, a into b plus c, where you open the bracket a into b plus a into c. So we will write 2 twos are 4x plus 2 twos are 4 plus 2 into x is 2x, which is equal to 154. Now this 2 are of the same type, that is 4x and 2x. We will add them together, 4, 5, 6x plus 4, which is equal to 154. Now the constant you can take on the other side using the method of transposition. Plus 4 will become minus 4. So we will write down 6x will be equal to 154 minus 4. So 6x is equal to 150. 154 minus 4 is 150. Now transfer 6. 6 is multiplied with x here, so when it goes on the other side it will be division. So therefore our x will be equal to 150 divided by 6. You can take the table of 2 or 3 to cancel it out. If you take the table of 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 5s are 15, 0, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10. Therefore, our x is equal to 25. So, the breadth x is equal to 25 meters. The length 2x plus 2 will be equal to 2 into 25 plus 2. 50 plus 2, which is equal to 52 meters. You put down the values into perimeter and it should be 154 meters.